Hello and welcome to the online learning session KNX DALI Gateway Premium DGS X6451 with the topic Color Function Dim to Warm. In this online learning session, lasting a maximum of 30 minutes, the focus is on a special function of a device, such as a Dim to Warm color function today. My name is Jürgen Schilder from the ABB Competence Center Europe Smart Buildings. Thorsten Reibel, Martin Vichari and I normally give online trainings from our office at ABB Stotzkontakt in Heidelberg or ABB Buschegger in Lüdenscheid. Due to the current situation, we are at home, in the home office, like many of you. So let's have a look at agenda first of all. At the beginning, we talk about dim to warm. What is it dim to warm? Why we can fulfill it together today with our DALI gateways. Then we come to the commissioning of the color function dim to warm, the ETS parameter settings, we have a look at the group objects and how we link the group objects of control element and the DALI gateway to do this dim to warm function. And how we can activate or deactivate, for example, the dim to warm functions, how the IBAS tool supports the DALI gateway. And at the end, we come to a practical demonstration. At the beginning, I would like to give you a short overview of our both DALI Gateway Premiums. Both devices have identical functions, but different number of DALI outputs. The DGS 16451 has one DALI output and the DGS 26451 two independent DALI outputs. So normal DALI ballast, device type 0, DALI single battery emergency lighting converters, device type 1, and colored controlled DALI ballast, device type 8, can be connected to both DALI gateways. The DALI gateways offers extensive functions that as templates, tunable white, human-centric lighting, dim to warm, or the flexible combination of groups or single control ballast on one output, and of course the support via IBAS, via our IBAS tool. So let's look back to the history. What is behind this dim to warm function? Everyone of you knows the old good light bulb. It was not an economical device, but it was very beautiful for dimming. So when this incandescent lamp was dimmed up, it becomes more warmer. The light becomes more yellow or, for example, like here, more really orange. So today we use LEDs. And LEDs, they have a fixed color temperature. So when a LED strip or LED spot is dimmed up or down, the same color temperature now still remains. But some customers, for example, in the residential market, they want to have exactly this feature of such a historical light bulb or halogen lamp. So when we dim darker, when we dim down, then the color temperature should change to warm light. And with our DALI gateway, exactly we can simulate this when we use DALI devices. So dim to warm means when we dim darker or brighter, the color temperature changes automatically. So this is also a parameter later in the ETS we can enable. Should it be deactivated or activated or always enabled, that's what we can do. So now, and typical application is in the residential market, like in family homes, for example, and the living room, when we have candles or cozy fireplaces, and the evening we dim darker, we dim down, then the color should really change to more warm light. Or in public buildings, like in hotel or restaurants, to have a kind of welcome feeling, or warm feeling, like here in the restaurant, or in the hotel bar. Or the morning and the breakfast, for example. So here you can see two pictures of a living room. On the left side, the brightness is here to a level of 30% and dimmed really up. So the color temperature is here about 3000 kelvins, which is the warm white. So on the right side, you can see the same picture dimmed up to 90% brightness. And then the color temperature changed here to 6500 Kelvin, which is the cold white. Later we'll see that we have here a linear relationship between our brightness and our color temperature. So with this dim to warm function, Yeah, we can exactly do the same like our typical incandescence lamps or our old light bulb. So now when we dim up, for example, from 20% here to 100%, the color temperature changed from 2000 to 6000 kelvins. These are the values we can later also set in the ETS. So for dimming up, we increase the color temperature and it becomes more cold white. And when we dim down, we decrease the color temperature and it becomes more warm white. So this two dim to warm function can be activated on a single group or a single ballast or more groups, of course. So it's not a feature of the complete output. We can do it also per group. But only one group can use this color function dim to warm or can use the human-centric lighting. So you have to decide what this group or this ballast is doing. So what do we need on equipment to do this dim to warm functions? So at first, of course, we need our DALI gateway, DGS-X6451, the device of the premium. So we need, of course, some KNX devices, KNX power supplies, control elements, and we need DALI driver of the device type 8, DT8, so-called. This is a DALI driver, which comes from a manufacturer called the Lunatone. Yeah, so we use this device here in our training, in our training center, and here you can see the manufacturer, the order code. So this DALI device has one address, so it's only one DALI device. So it is between it is used for cold white and warm white LED and with a constant voltage output. It needs a supply voltage 12 to 80 volt DC. It depends on the supply voltage here of our LED spots. So maximum 4 amps, so we can here connect also parallel more than one LED spots, but no more than 4 amps. So what else? Our power adapter for the supply voltage, 12 or 24 volt DC, and some LED spots or LED strips tunable white. Also here with constant voltage, CV constant voltage. So this must match together, the spot, and of course here our ballast, both have here, are from the type constant voltage. So this is a spot I use here, we use also in our training center, which comes from Constellate, also manufacturer. You see here the type is about 750 lumen and his color temperature is between 2200 and 6500 kelvins. You see here is a little bit different. The ballast only 3000 to 6500 kelvins. So we have later to set this value here in our ATS parameter because these are our physical min color temperature value and the physical, the maximum physical value. So this is the hardware we need here to do such a typical dim to warm function. Good, then let's come to the ETS parameter. So at first we have to set the ETS parameter and the DALI output A or B and the group or on the ballast. So we can do it in the template or we can use it individual. So this is what I show you in the next slide step by step. But in principle, we have to at first to enable the color function dim to warm for the group or for the ballast. Then we have to set the parameter. What about the state when KNX voltage recovers or we have or after download and the reaction when the DALI gateway receives a color temperature or a dim command or someone calls the scene. So then we go to our output, to the complete output. And the complete output we can enable a group object to activate for all ballast the dim to warm function and we can use the limitation function of the color temperature and the brightness. So now let's do it step by step. Before we come to these parameters, some words about our templates. This is not a new feature of our DALI gateways, also the DGS-X6411 and our new switch actuator use this templates solution. So what is the template? Here in our DALI gateway, on one output, we can have up to 64 individual ballasts or 16 groups. So you must parameterize all of these ballasts, the groups, you set the parameters for status, burn-in, partial failure, functions, and all the things. So you need a lot of time, and in a lot of projects, you have the same type of ballast. So, and this is very time intensive. So we have these templates and with the template solution, we create one template and later in the group on the ballast, we can say this group should use the template or individual settings. So this really simplifies the parameterization here with the ETS. Good, here you can see the overview. At first, we have a template. In a template, we set the parameters for the status, for the fault, for the functions and all other things. And here for dim to warm, also for the color temperature. So then we start with the settings of the group number one. Group number one, the first about the status. Would we like to use the template? And then we tick here in group number one, status, yes, use the template. Or say, no, I want to use not template. I want to use individual settings. And then you click here individual, and then you get the same parameters like in the template, but this is only valid here for the group number one. And the same for the fault, use the template individually, blah, blah, blah. And at the end, you come to the next group, to the next ballast and so on. So this is the principle of these templates. Good, then let's start. We are beginning in the group. So we go here to the submenu, group, ballast, and I start here, or I use here the templates, which really simplifies my work. I go here to the template. I do all the parameter settings for status, fault, blah, blah, blah. And in the last submenu here, we have color temperature TC. The template for our groups and ballast. Okay, I go here on the right side, and here we have use color function. We can say no, the no color function is used for in the template for the group or ballast. We can say dim to warm, exactly that's what we know, what we want to have, or the central color temperature, the HCL. This is what we also can select. So do not forget, in a group or ballast, we can use only one color function, the dim to warm, or the central color temperature. So we select, of course, here dim to warm. Then we come to the next parameter. What about the state after KNX recovery and the download? Three possibilities: default, like before failure, and then I think it's not difficult when we make a download or the KNX bus voltage comes back. Then it depends if before the color function was activated, then it's still activated. Was it before deactivated? And then it's deactivated. Or we can say fixed, activated, or fixed, deactivated. This is also possible. So the next parameter, when color function is active and the device receives a set color temperature command. What is it? So the DALI gateway, here my group number one, we have a group object called set color temperature. This is a 2-byte value. So via a device, it is possible to send a color temperature value between 3000 and 6500 kelvins, and then the device adopt these values. So what should happen? Well, now this dim to warm function is active and he receives a set color temperature value. Ignore or deactivate the function and adopt this new color temperature value. Default, it is ignore. So the next parameter, similar, but here when the device receives a dimming command of dimming for the color temperature. So we have here, for example, the group number one, output A, the object dim color temperature. This is a 4-bit because this comes from a control element, a rocker, which works like a dimmer because we dim our color temperature relative, up and down. So what should the output do? Ignore, or the ballast do? Ignore or deactivate the function and adopt this new dimming command. And the third one is when someone calls a scene, what should happen? Ignore the scene or deactivate the dim to warm function and adopt the color temperature value of the scene. So here are the settings in the group, per group, or per ballast. So then we come to the settings of the complete output. So we go here in our menu, A output. Here we have the submenus, status, fault, functions, and again, color function. So in this output A color functions, we have some more parameters. One is enable group object output activate dim to warm color function. Yes or no, default it is no. So when we enable it, we say yes. And then we get a group object, which is output A, activate dim to warm color function. This is a 1-bit object. So via a 1-bit group object, group address, here we can activate the dim to warm function for all groups and ballast of this output number A, like a centrally command. But do not forget, This feature must be parameterized in the ballast and in the groups, of course. So this is like one KNX telegram to activate in all maximum 64 ballast the DIM2WARM functions. Good, okay, more parameters we don't have. You see, it is not really difficult to do the settings. So how we can now activate or deactivate this DIM2WARM function? So at first, minimum, we have the objects per group. Like for example, here on the right side, we have output A, our group object, output A group number one, activate DIM2WARM color function. So via one bit telegram with the value one, we activate the DIM2WARM color function for our group number one, and with the zero, we deactivate it. The same when we work with ballast, individual control ballast, and then of course we have here the object for my ballast number three, also activate or deactivate. And if you want to enable to activate the DIM2WARM function for the complete output A, then we can do it via this object, like I shown you before, activate DIM2WARM color function for the complete output. So we have here the possibilities to do it individually per group, ballast, and centrally for all ballasts and output. So let's come to another nice feature, to the, let me say, limitation of our relationship between brightness and color temperature. So on the right side, you can see here a picture of the relationship between our luminous flux, which is here on the x-axis, and our color temperature on the y-axis. So here on the x-axis, we have our luminous flux. This is the emitted light by our lamp, which is normally from 0 to 100% brightness. And we have on the y-axis our color temperature, with the minimum color temperature of our ballast, for example, the 3000 Kelvin, and the maximum color temperature. And between the color temperature and our brightness, we have a proportional range. Via some ETS parameter, we can modify or we can change here our limitations. Now, let's show you step by step how we can change here our so-called proportional range. So at first, we have the possibility to say, oh, we don't want to have this limitation, no limitation of the proportional range, and no limitation of the temperature range, and then we have exactly here this picture. So we have here, again, our luminous flux. This is the brightness emitted by our lamp, which you see on this axis, and here we have the color temperature. So when we start here at the minimum brightness level, you see here our proportional range, we have a linear relationship between the color temperature and our brightness range. So when we dim here, when we dim up, and then linear the color temperature change here from the minimum color temperature, which is exactly our DIM2WARM minimum color temperature, to the maximum brightness 100% with our maximum color temperature, which is also the DIM2WARM maximum color temperature. These are exactly the default settings. The next step is we can limit our range. So we can say, no, I want to limit my proportional range, which is my brightness, for example, between 20 and 80%. So what does it mean? So we'll see it on the next screen. So here we have our lower brightness limit, which is here our 20%, and we have our upper brightness limit, for example, our 80%. Here we have in the middle between our lower and upper brightness limit, our brightness range, our so-called proportional range. Here in this range, we have a linear relationship between our brightness and our color temperature. So when we switch the light on and the DIM2WARM function is activated from zero, for example, to 20%, we have here the minimum color temperature, like for example, our 3000 Kelvin, and then more than 20%, when we dim here up, then we have the linear relationship and the color temperature change linear. So when we reach here our maximum, our upper brightness limit 80%, and then we reach here our maximum, for example, our 6500 Kelvins, until between 80% and 100%. It's one solution with this limitation. Or vice versa, we say, no, we don't limit our proportional brightness range. We limit, for example, Yeah, the color temperature range, like here, 2700 to 4000 kelvins. So what does it mean? When we look again here on this picture, we have the complete brightness here on the x-axis from 0 to 100%. We have here our minimum color temperature. This is the minimum physical value of the ballast, like the 3000 kelvins. And we have the maximum color temperature, for example, our 6500. And between here, we have our dim-to-warm maximum color temperature, and we have the dim-to-warm minimum color temperature. Like before, our 2700 and 4000 kelvins. So now, when we start dimming, we switch on. He jumps, for example, to 1%. Then he jumps here to the minimum dimming color temperature, like, for example, our value like before. And then we have here the proportional range between 0 and 100%, but between here our dim to warm minimum and maximum color temperature. So, and last but not least, the possibility number 4, we mix everything. So we say, okay, we want to have a limitation of our brightness range between 20 and 80%. And we want to have a limitation in the color temperature range between 2700 and 4000. What does it mean? You see here, we have our limitation in the brightness range between 20% and 80%. And here from our minimum color temperature, the physical minimum value, maximum value, and between, we have the dim to warm minimum and maximum values. And between here, we have still our proportional range. To see it here with real values, you see here a screenshot. For example, in the ETS, we set a parameter. Like here, the lower brightness limit is 20 to 80%. You see here, this is the lower brightness limit, 20%, up to 80%. This is here our proportional range. So we have here the linear relationship. And the minimum color temperature and the maximum color temperature is 2700 and 4000. So we have, for example, here 4000. Here we have 2700. Now when we switch on with 10%, and then we have here 2700 kelvins. When we reach the brightness here of 20%, and then the color temperature changes proportionally until we reach 80%, then we reach here the maximum, our 4000 maximum color temperature for dim to warm, and from 80 to 100%, we have still the same value like our 4000 kelvins. So this is the principle of this limitation. So we can limit the proportional range, our brightness range here, and we can also limit the color temperature range. So everything here is still possible. Good, then let's come to an example. I want to show you in real, in practice, how it works. So I have here a KNX training DALI board with the DALI gateway DGS26451. And some KNX control elements. So on the DALI output, I have connected two DALI device type 8 ballasts. So important, DALI device type DT8. So this DALI driver has one address, and the second one has the same also one address. And both of these DALI devices belongs to my group number 1. And via control element, I can control my group number 1 with the rocker 1 for switching and dimming. With rocker number 2, I can send a brightness value, like on the left side, example 30%, on the right side of the rocker 75%. And with rocker number 3, I can set here the color temperature, like for example 4000 Kelvin and 5000 Kelvin. And with the rocker number 4, I can dim the color temperature relative, from my 3000 up to 6500 Kelvin, for example. Good, with another sensor like my control element 1, I can control my complete output, all my 64 ballasts, my output A for switching, dimming, brightness value and so on. And with the second control element, I use the rocker number 1 to activate the dim to warm function for the complete output, output A, rocker number 2 for scene control, and with rocker number 4 only to activate the dim to warm function in my group number 1. Remember, we can activate the dim-to-warm function per group or for the complete output. Good, so then let's do it. Before I showed you in real how we have to link the group objects. So let's give you an example. Here on the left side, we see the group objects of the DALI gateway with the output A for switching, dimming, brightness, So with the control element, I use one rocker for switching on and off my complete output, one for dimming. With the rocker number 2, I send a value. With rocker number 3, I send here a color temperature value. This belongs all to my output number A. And with the second rocker of my second control element, I can call a scene. Good. Next step, to control my group number 1, I have another control element. And with this control element, I want to switch on and off. So I need here rocker 1 short, rocker 1 long. I can dim darker and brighter the brightness. I use the LEDs to use the status information to control the LEDs. And with rocker number 2, for example, I can send here a value, like for example, for switching, maybe to 30% and 70% of brightness. Rocker number 3 for sending a temperature value between 3000 or 6500 kelvins, and with rocker number 4, for example, I use it for relative dimming of the color temperature. So here, like dimming darker and brighter, here for dimming the color temperature. Okay, this is how we have to link the group objects between our control elements and our DALI gateway to use this dim-to-warm function. And one slide, the last slide you will see, is that we need also a group address to activate the dim-to-warm function for the complete output if you want, like here with the rocker number 1 or here with the rocker number 4, to activate or deactivate it per group. So with this rocker, I can activate it or deactivate it only for my group number 1. It's exactly that, what I have live here. And our IBUS tool, I show it you also live. Good, then let's come to a practical demonstration. So I share now my desktop with you and show you everything now live. Just a second, please. So I would like to begin this practical demonstration with a small video clip. This is like in a living room, in a residential home, to use this dim-to-warm function. You see we are 100% brightness, then dimming down, you see it becomes more warmer the light. It is a bit flickering because the brightness goes also down. And then for example we are here really dark, warm white, and then we dim again here brighter, dim up, and you see the color temperature changed to more cold white. Let's have a look at the group objects of the ETS. So remember, we start here on our DALI output A or B, it doesn't matter, and go here to the menu of our templates. Templates, we have all different templates for status, for fault, slave template, but we go here to the submenu color temperature template for the groups and ballast. So at first we need some information, some data of our ballast. Here this ballast has a physical min value of 3000 Kelvin and a maximum of 6500. So this information we get from the manufacturer technical data sheet. So everything else we keep it like it is, and at the end we have here our parameter use color function. No dim to warm or central color temperature HCL. We want to have dim to warm, so we click here and select the dim to warm. So then we come here to the parameter state after KNX recovery and download, like before the failure, or deactivated or activated. You say no, like before. And the three parameters, what should happen when the color function is active. And there is a set color temperature command or a dim command, or someone calls a scene, ignore or deactivate the function, and adapt this new value. So this what we can do here in the template. Next step is we go to our groups, like for example my group number 1. I start here with the group number 1 status, fault, functions, and then I come here to my color temperature, to my submenu, and then I can decide would I like to use my template, which I have done before. Yes, sure. Or no, I want to use individual values settings, and then I can use here the individual. But it's quite easier to use my values from the template. The same in my group number 2. I can go also here to my color temperature settings and say again, use this also the template. So all my groups, group 2, 3, 10, 15, Then I come to my ballast, the individually controlled ballast, like for example here my ballast number 12, the same status fault functions and color temperature TC. I can also decide would I like to use my template like before or the individual values. Of course, I use again here the template. So that's what we have to do per group and ballast. Good, and then we come to the next topic, to our complete output. Output A, here we have again a submenu color functions, and here we can enable the parameter. Would we like to have a group object to activate the color temperature function for the complete output A, yes or no? So when I say yes, then you will see we get here a new group object, which is the group object number 65, and 65 is output A activate dim to warm color function. It's a one bit. So when we send here one, and then for all ballasts and groups, the dim to warm function is activated of the output A. So else output A color function, and here we can use these limitations of our proportional range. We say no or yes. Remember, then we have here the 20 to 80% or other values. Yeah, what do you prefer? And if you want to use the limitation of the color temperature range, then you can use your values, like for example, between, let me say, 3,800 and 4,500 Kelvins. Only for example, what you like to use. Good, these are all the settings we have to make. Would you like to have this object for centrally dim to warm function for the complete output? And would you like to use here these limitations of the brightness range and color temperature range? Then we continue and link the group addresses. So when we have a look at our group number one, we have the typical objects for switching, dimming, brightness level. And then when we have a tunable white DT8 ballast, then we can set here also the color temperature via 2-byte telegram, or we can dim the color temperature between our 3000 and 6500 values. And here we have then the activate dim to warm color function group object. So here when we set a value 1, then only the dim to warm function for my group number 1 is activated, or with the value 0 deactivated. Good, so far here the parameter, and then let's close the ATS. So the last step is, for example, to show you everything live. And the IBUS tool, before I show you everything live, and the IBUS tool, we can see which color function is selected for this group or for my ballast. And additionally, for example, if the color function is activated or deactivated. Just a second, the IBUS tool now tries to connect to my DALI gateway. So, okay, here's my DALI output with all my DALI ballasts and my tunable white lights. Let's come here to my group number one. Group number one, we have here the color function. When you go here on the right side, color selected color function dim to warm. You see in the ETS, I have parameterized my group number one, use the dim to warm color function. And at the moment, the color function is inactive, so it's not activated. So via a KNX telegram, you see here, it's now active. Yeah, or again, I can deactivate it. So here the IBUS tool gives us the information which color function is parameterized and if it's active or deactive. Good, so then let's come to my practical demonstration. So now I switch off the light here in my room. So, and here I have the DALI gateway and my LED spots. Now I switch on here the spots. So at the moment I have deactivated the dim to warm function. So now when I dim now up, you see the color temperature will not change. It's always, maybe I want, what is it? 3000 Kelvin. So I can dim darker, I can dim down the color temperature. And now you see it's always the same, a typical warm white. So now I activate the dim to warm function. Press one rocker and send the command. I switch on again. You see, it is still dim to warm, maybe 10%. I dim now up. And now when I dim up, you see the color temperature changed from warm white now to cold white. See the difference? Yeah, before it was always warm white, and now it's changed from warm white to cold white. And now when I dim down, yeah, you see the light becomes more warm. Yeah, it goes maybe here to my 3000 Kelvin or something. So this is a typical behavior like we have it in our incandescence lamps. Yeah, or when I send here, for example, a value, a brightness value, go to 50%, yeah, then it's also maybe, I don't know, what is it, 4000 Kelvins or something. And then I dim here to 100, and then you see the behavior that it becomes really here cold white. Okay, I hope that you have seen a little bit that it works, the principle. It's not perfect here. Okay, I think one problem is here my webcam with this automatically. This is, what's the English word? The white balance, which tries to make here the best balance between cold white and warm white. But in principle, this is here dim to warm, full brightness, cold white, dim darker, here warm white. Good. Okay, so far this function dim to warm. A small summary. Remember, the LEDs, the color temperature of typical LEDs does not change like we have it before in our incandescence lamps. But with this dim to warm function, we can do it. We can use LEDs together with our DALI gateway for this typical, like then we have the same behavior like our light bulbs. And this is special solution, for example, used in residential or some commercial buildings like in hotels, restaurants and bars. So when we dim up, we increase the color temperature, it becomes more cold white. When we dim down, we decrease the color temperature, it becomes more warm white. So the dim to warm function can activate it on a group ballast via Koenigs telegram or via central to all ballasts of one channel. So very important that one ballast or one group can be only use the color function dim to warm or human centric lighting. And of course we need ballast from the device type 8, tunable white. Here for example you see a typical LED strip. We see the warm white and the cold white LED. So we have here two LEDs, the same we have here in our LED spot. And here we have one is the common and one is here the supply voltage for the warm white and for the cold white. Depending on the commands from the DALI gateway, the ballast mixed here between warm and cold. Some slides at the end. Everything about our products you can find on abb.com/Koenigs. Then you go to products downloads and especially for the DALI gateways, go to lighting control and to the DALI gateways. We have a wide range of DALI gateways. Go here to the DALI gateways premium, the manual and everything else. So further informations about our webinars, for example, e-learnings, presentations, video tutorials, everything what we have, engineering guides from Arno's engineering team, you will find on our training qualification database. We have here a special link or also via abb.com/Koenigs. Our video clips from the webinar recordings and video tutorials you can find also on YouTube. Go to YouTube and we have here also a special channel. So training qualification calendar is also online. Here you can find everything about our trainings, but at the moment all trainings are cancelled until end of June, and I hope we can start with our training in Heidelberg and Lüdenscheid again in July. One of our first training in July is our Koenigs certified course in the middle of July. It fulfills the requirements of the Koenigs Association. Advanced course is, for example, HVAC, security and logical operations and some more things. So the tutor course for internal, for ABB colleagues, for colleagues who wants to become a Koenigs tutor in October, and again a basic course in November for someone who starts with Koenigs, for new ABB colleagues, for example, is also recommended to attend this basic course. And more information is on our website. Our next webinar will take place on the 6th of May in the morning, 9 o'clock and 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Everything about all special functions of the DALI gateway, not only the dim to warm, of course it's a topic, the standby switch off, the scenes, the one-bit scenes, the ABB IBUS tool, for example with the search function, how we can read out the operation hours of a ballast, such things, human-centric lighting, and a lot of more topics. You will also get invitation emails before. So some words about our further online learning session today. This was the first time that we started here with this online learning sessions. Next Thursday, we continue with the so-called standby switch-off function of the DALI gateway. Then next week on Tuesday with this human-centric lighting. And on Thursday the 23rd with a special topic, nothing to do with a KNX product from ABB, so about the ETS group addresses. Every one of you maybe, I think, uses the three-level addresses, but the ETS allows also the free address style. What is it? Does it make sense to use the free address style? Yeah, or how we can generate our group addresses in Microsoft Excel via drag and drop, copy and paste, and then import it in the ETS. So how to work faster with Microsoft Excel. So this is also a special topic here on Thursday. And then we continue on the 28th with Control Touch. This is given by my colleague Martin Bihari for the next four sessions. So this is what is planned. And of course, you will get also invitations to this next block of the next online learning sessions. Good, so far I think we are at the end of this online learning session. So now we come to the end for today. Yeah, the 30 minutes passed very quickly. I think we had no technical problems. Everything works really fine. I'm really happy about this. I would like to say thank you for your participation. Do not forget, next Thursday, the next online learning session, the morning 9:30 and 3:30 in the afternoon about this standby switch off function. From my side, I would decide to say have a nice day and greetings from my home. Goodbye and stay healthy. Goodbye.